The whale, marine mammal of the order Cetacea. They comprise three groups, one Archaeocetae, believed to have been derived from the Credonta, the primitive fossil members of the carnivora. Their teeth consist of three incisors, one canine, four premolars, and 3 to 2 molars on either side of each jaw. A milk dentition is found. Two, Mystacocetae, or whalebone whales, in which the mouth contains fine plate-like structures supported by the palate in place of teeth. And three, Odontocetae, or toothed whales, believed to have descended from the Archaeocetae, which includes sperm whales, dolphins, and porpoises. The most prized species is the blue whale, the largest of all animals, which is found chiefly in the Antarctic Ocean. It reaches a length of 100 feet and a weight of at least 120 tons. Whales are migrant animals, the movements of which are conditioned by surface temperatures and by their search for food. Blue, fin, and humpback whales enter the Antarctic in summer and feed on vast shoals of southern krill, an oceanic shrimp some 2.5 inches long, which feeds on single-celled plants called phytoplankton. In winter, they frequent the warmer latitudes to breed. The sperm whale is the largest toothed whale. It attains a length of 60 feet, but the male is much larger than the female and is polygamous. Fin and humpback whales may reach lengths of 65 and 50 feet respectively. Whales are warm-blooded, breathe air, and have lungs. The skin is naked, but they conserve their body heat by immense layers of blubber, from which enormous quantities of whale oil are produced. The bulk of this oil is processed into margarine, but there are many useful byproducts, for example, frozen whale meat, meat meal, meat extracts, bone meal, liver oil, and vitamin extracts. Whales bear their young like lamb mammals. The breeding of whalebone whales takes place in low latitudes in winter, and pregnancy lasts for about a year. Only one calf is born, and this is nursed for about 7 months, after which the parent rests until the next breeding season. Statistics on the whaling industry are compiled annually by the Norwegian Committee for Whaling Statistics. After World War II, the International Whaling Commission was formed, and most governments whose nationals engage in whaling are members of it. The major field for whaling is the Antarctic, and here only a certain number of whales is permitted to be caught in any season. There are, however, also comprehensive regulations for whaling in all parts of the world. A recent development in the industry is whale marking. This was begun in 1926 by the Discovery Committee, and prior to World War II, some 5,000 whales had been marked in the Antarctic, chiefly by the William Scoresby, a vessel stretched to the line of the Germans. In 1953, a whale marking expedition was jointly financed by the whaling companies of the British Commonwealth.
Ist das ein Grandis-Super?